Dear friends, welcome back! This is Nick from edukids.tv and today I am going to show you how to connect our familiar $5 1.8-inch color TFT display to the OpenMV camera module and display live data to it. Let's get started! A few months ago, I reviewed the impressive OpenMV M7 camera. If you are not familiar with it, the OpenMV camera module is a new port that aims to bring machine vision closer to makers. They want to make machine vision easy and fun to use. The board features a camera module and a very powerful processor, which can be programmed using MicroPython. Please check the detailed video review of the OpenMV camera for more details. The more I use this camera module, the more I understand how capable this thing really is. The specs are fantastic. The creators of the board have also created some add-on seals for it to further improve its potential. One of the most useful seals for a beginner is the LCD seal, because it allows you to debug your OpenMV script without the need of a computer. After taking a closer look at the LCD seal, I discovered that it uses our familiar 1.8-inch color TFT display. If you are a long-time viewer of the channel, you know that I love this display, and I have used it many times in the past with Arduino. It is very easy to use, it offers a resolution of 160 by 128 pixels, it is fast, and it is inexpensive. It costs just $5. You can find a link to it in the description of the video below, and of course, a link to the LCD seal from OpenMV. So, I took a close look at the LCD seal and I managed to get the pins we need to connect. I connected a display to the OpenMV M7 cam and it works great. Of course, the display will work with the newer OpenMV H7 camera as well. Let me now show you how to connect it. The connection is very easy. We only need to connect 8 pins to make it work. VCC goes to the 3.3V output of the OpenMV camera module. Ground goes to ground. CS goes to pin P3. Reset to P7. A0 to P8. SDA to P0. SCK to P2. And lastly, the LED pin goes to the 3.3V output of the OpenMV cam as well. That's it. Our display is ready to use. You can use the display like this if you wish, but it is not very practical with all these wires around. You can easily build your own shield like I did using a small prototyping board and start experimenting with the OpenMV camera. Now, let's see the software we need to make it work. Since the display we are using is the same with the one the OpenMV LCD shield uses, we don't need any libraries to make it work. We only need to connect our OpenMV board to the computer, load the OpenMV IDE, and open the LCD shield example and run it. That's it! Our display is working fine and it displays live images from the sensor. Amazing stuff! The resolution is not high, just 160 by 128 pixels, but it is enough for many useful things. All we have to do to use the display is to import the LCD module in a script, initialize the display, and then we are ready to print something to it. With the command LCD display image, we display the frame buffer to the screen, in other words, a snapshot from the camera. If we want to print text or shapes to the display, we have to manipulate the image object, which offers many functions to achieve anything we want. For example, I have modified a simple script that comes with the OpenMV IDE. In this example, the OpenMV camera can identify April tags. April tags are similar to QR codes, but they encode far smaller data payloads between 4 and 12 bits, allowing them to be detected more robustly and from longer ranges. Further, they are designed for high localization accuracy. You can compute the precise 3D position of the April tag with respect to the camera. I printed an April tag on my printer and now the OpenMV cam can easily identify it. Since we are using the display, we don't need to be connected to the computer to debug the script. We print debug data directly on the display. In this example, I print the text "turn left" when identifying the ripple tag, as well as the frame rate of the script. As always, you can find the code of the script in the description of the video below. We can build some cool robot project using ripple tags. That's what I'm planning to do next, build a robot that can identify ripple tags and act accordingly. It will be fun and we are going to learn a lot of things in the process. This LCD display shield I built is going to make things much easier, since I won't have to carry the laptop around. Next, I will try to drive the robot motors using the OpenMV camera module and prepare a video. So, stay tuned. I would love to know your opinion about the OpenMV robot idea. Do you think it will be interesting? Please post your comments or ideas below. Thank you very much for your comments and for watching this video. I hope it will save you some time. I'll see you soon.